Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Saturday, Memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphone. God is in His holy place, God who unites those who dwell in His house. He Himself gives might and strength to His people.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant, O Lord God, that we, your servants, may rejoice in unfailing health of mind and body, and through the glorious intercession of Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, may we be set free from present sorrow and come to enjoy eternal happiness through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The priests and prophets said to the princes and to all the people, "This man deserves death. He has prophesied against this city, as you have heard with your own ears." Jeremiah gave this answer to the princes and all the people. "It was the Lord who sent me to prophesy against this house and city, all that you have heard. Now, therefore, reform your ways and your deeds. Listen to the voice of the Lord your God, so that the Lord will repent of the evil with which he threatens you. As for me, I am in your hands. Do with me what you think good and right. But mark well, if you put me to death, it is innocent blood you bring on yourselves, on this city and its citizens. For in truth it was the Lord who sent me to you to speak all these things for you to hear." Thereupon the princes and all the people said to the priest and the prophets, "This man does not deserve death. It is in the name of the Lord our God that he speaks to us." So Ahikam, son of Shaphan, protected Jeremiah so that he was not handed over to the people to be put to death. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
Rescue me out of the mire, may I not sink. May I be rescued from my foes and from the watery depths. Let not the flood waters overwhelm me, nor the abyss swallow me up, nor the pit close its mouth over me.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
But I am afflicted and in pain. Let your saving help, O God, protect me. I will praise the name of God in song, and I will glorify him with thanksgiving.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
See, you lowly ones, and be glad. You who seek God, may your hearts revive. For the Lord hears the poor, and his own who are in bonds, he spurns not.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Herod the Tetrarch heard of the reputation of Jesus and said to his servants, "This man is John the Baptist. He has been raised from the dead. That is why mighty powers are at work within him." Now Herod had arrested John, bound him, and put him in prison on account of Herodias, the wife of his brother Philip. For John had said to him, "It is not lawful for you to have her." Although he wanted to kill him, he feared the people, for they regarded him as a prophet. But at the birthday celebration for Herod, the daughter of Herodias performed a dance before the guests and delighted Herod so much that he swore to give her whatever she might ask for. Prompted by her mother, she said, "Give me here on a platter the head of John the Baptist." The king was distressed, but because of his oaths and the guests who were present, he ordered it be given. He had beheaded John in prison. His head was brought in on a platter and given to the girl who took it to her mother. His disciples came and took away the corpse and buried him, and they went and told Jesus. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, today, and as we mentioned yesterday, you know, the Gospel that we were reflecting on was also a question of the need to make our choices, you know, in the sense that we are certain confronted, we are at times rather confronted with certain dilemmas, no? And therefore, we need to make choices. And the Gospel yesterday showed us how our biases, no, our prejudices can get into the way, no, of making a very good and a free choice, no. Perhaps that's the best word to describe it—a free choice, no. So here you have that again. No? You have in a sense a repetition of that theme, no. And here you have now that struggle between, I guess it's the moral struggle, no. It's knowing what is right, and yet being influenced by other factors. So that's the first point that we will reflect on, no. And reflecting on that, I'd like to deepen that particular moral dilemma as our plight, no. It's really each and every one of us goes through that plight, that dilemma, no. And then the third and last point is that how really an openness to grace can help us resolve the dilemma, no. Here in the case of Herod, no. So when the daughter of Herodias, no, asked for the head of John the Baptist, he was distressed, no. He knew that it was wrong. And remember, Herod, no, in other versions, also in other parts also of the Gospel, he was fascinated by John the Baptist, actually. Then later on, he is described as someone who wanted to hear Jesus also. So you could see that there is an interior movement, no, for him to seek what is moral, what is right, no. There's a certain desire or hunger for him to know, no, to listen, no, to what is right and to what is moral, no. And yet you realize now, no, that he ended up not following his conscience, you know, if you wish to put it that way, no. But there is that struggle between our interior compass, so to speak, our interior moral compass, and the influences of the world, no. So here you have that very clearly in Herod. He was distressed in the sense that he knew that it would be wrong, and yet at the same time, what carried the greater weight was that his reputation, no, to others. So maybe that first point to reflect on, how do we go through that own struggle, no? How do we, what are those instances that we ourselves, no, went through that struggle? And the second point is a deepening of the process that happens, no, when we are confronted with such a plight or such a struggle, no? And for me, I'd like to invite you to reflect on the letter of Paul to the Romans. I think it's chapter 7, no? Where, remember, Paul says, no, I know the good that I want to do, no? And yet I end up doing what is wrong, no? Then he cries out and asks for God's grace and God's help, no? And for me, that is all of us, that is our struggle. That deep down, there is a certain sense of what is morally right, what is right, what is just. And yet very often we end up doing what is the opposite, no? And here again, and this is the third point now, no? Here is where we need to pray for grace, no? And the openness to grace in our lives, no? You know, one of the things that I always realize when I hear confessions and when I try to sort of give advice or counsel people, I always tell them that, you know, it's very difficult to deal with our shortcomings, no? And with our mistakes, no? And very often my own experience, and I think the experience of many, is that we can overcome our sinfulness, our sinful patterns, our mistakes, no, our faults. Yes, through awareness, through acceptance, and through effort. But when everything is said and done, there is also the need for grace, no? To ask for the grace that we need and to allow that grace to help us transform and to undergo a deeper conversion, no? I think that is the third and last point that I invite you to reflect on, no? I think I'd like you to think of one image, no, and perhaps a grace to pray for. A grace to pray for that we are able to stand firm on our values, no, on our own moral, and to follow our moral compass, no. The Tagalog word is very vivid, no, manindigan, no, to stand firm on core values and our moral compass. Siguro maganda ngayong araw na mapagnilayan natin itong palay ko napakahalagang aral, no, napakahalagang masasabi natin na tema ng ating buhay, no, kasi karamihan sa atin, halos lahat tayo, ano yan eh, merong pagtutunggali yung kabutihan at kasamaan sa atin. Alam natin ang kabutihan pero kadalasan sa katapusan, ano, nagagawa natin yung mali, no, bagaman alam natin kung ano yung tama, no. At makikita natin sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw, no, tandaan natin si Herod, gusto niyang makinig kay San Juan Bautista nung narinig niya si Kristo, gusto niya rin mapakinggan. So makikita niyo na meron sa kanyang kalooban ang isang pagnanais, no, na makinig ang tama, makinig sa mga bagay na mga aral na pwedeng magpalalim ng kanyang masasabing moralidad, ano. Nandun 'yon eh. Pero makita natin na dito sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw na ang nanaig ay ang impluwensya ng ibang tao, yung kanyang reputasyon. At kadalasan yan din ang ating ano, yan din ang ating dinadaan ng pagtutunggali sa ating kalooban. At yung pangalawang punto ay sabi nga ni San Pablo sa mga sulat niya sa mga Romano, alam ko naman yung dapat na gawin, yung tama. Pero sa katapusan, ginagawa ko pa rin yung mali, no? At yun din yung ating karanasan, di ba? Yan din yung ating karanasan. At ito nga ang ano, no? ito yung pangatlong punto. Dahil yun ang napakalalim ng pagtutunggaling yun. Sabi nga ni San Pablo, no, na nung, sa katapusan, nung kanyang binabanggit yun, sabi niya sa katapusan, kailangan ko ng biyaya ng Diyos. Tayo rin, no? Na, alam niyo, lagi kong sinasabi noon, yung parang advice ko sa kumpisa, lalo na nung nagtatrabaho pa ako sa eskwelahan, sabi ko palagi sa mga tao, hilingin mo yung biyaya sa Diyos upang madaig mo yung kasamaan, di ba? Yung pattern ng kasalanan sa ating buhay. Kasi bagaman mahalaga yung kamulatan, yung pagtanggap, yung paghilom ng mga maling masasabi natin pattern sa ating buhay, sa katapusan, mahalaga ang biyaya upang malampasan natin at madaig natin, ano, yung ating masasabing pagkiling sa paggawa ng mali, no. So today let's pray for this, no, for the grace of overcoming our sinful patterns, no, for the grace of teaching us to stand firm, no, as I said, no, yung manindigan kung ano ang tama, manindigan kung ano ang ayon sa ating pananampalataya. So let us pray for this, let us pray that we may be given these graces. Gathered together in Christ who conquers all evil, let us come confidently to the Father with our prayerful intentions.
That the Church may be renewed and give faithful witness to the proper values of life, and so help restore a fallen world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That warring nations may learn to live in harmony and mutual cooperation in bringing peace to the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may give wholehearted support in upholding the truth and in opposing the subtle influences of evil. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. We pray also most especially for the good health of the Holy Father Pope Francis. We pray for all of his intentions, especially his prayers for peace. Let's continue to pray for all those who suffered because of the recent Typhoon Karina and the floods. Let's also pray for all those who are helping them. We pray also for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, you conceive your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer the Oratio Imperata for peace.
God, our Heavenly Father, Lord of peace and justice, we humbly come before you during this time of escalating geopolitical tensions in our part of the world. Through the years, you have sustained our faith in you as a nation. It is our faith in your divine providence that has made us survive the countless natural and human-caused calamities that have come our way in our history as a people. Spare us, Lord, from the horrors of war. Hear our pleas as we cry out to you. Have mercy on us, Lord. Rescue us from the malevolent forces that influence world leaders. For we believe that our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. We pray for our leaders entrusted with making crucial decisions for our nation. We place all our hopes in you, seeking your forgiveness and mercy for the times when our fears and suspicions have tainted our perceptions with ethnic biases and prejudices verging on racism. We earnestly pray, Lord, that you make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us bring love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady, Queen of Peace,
pray for us.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Francis of Assisi,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Loyola,
pray for us. And let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat, and have a good day ahead and have a good weekend ahead. Thank you po.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.